Hello, my name is Christoph, and in this second part, we will install Python. You will find the links after this video in the video description under this video. Here we select the x86-bit installer for 32-bit computers and the 64-bit installer for 64-bit computers. I have a 64-bit computer, so as you see here, we will take this one. After the download, we start it. We say all users next. We let the default path on the C drive say next, and this is the most important step. We select here entire feature will be installed on local hard drive. This means that all sub features and functions and all that stuff with Python will be installed to work. This includes also the Python installer adds the Python to the command line, so you can use Python from the command line. Then you click next and wait a bit. Now the installer has finished. A second part, we install Scala, we download it, and then we start the installer, and we say next, agree, next. And here also is the most important step here is to select here entire feature will be installed on local hard drive. That includes also the integration here into the command line of Windows. We say next and install it. Now the installation has finished. If we now start an administrative command line, but administrative is not necessary, you can type Python, say enter, and now you have the Python console and you see here and here that you are using Python. I will make this a little bit bigger. So, and now we can say, for example, print hello world, and it writes hello world. We can exit this with exit, or with exit in this case like this one. Now we can say Scala and we get access to the console of Scala. And now we can say print hello world and it prints. Now we can say exit. And now we are in the console of Windows. Now we have installed Scala and Python for the command line. If you want to use it with Eclipse, you have to watch the next video.